Petrotrin has resumed bunkering operations. This follows the one-year wet lease charter of the tanker Valme B, which arrived in Trinidad at the end of March 2017.
The idea here is that in 2015, as late as fourth quarter 2015, we had done a review of our bunkering operations with the Marbella barge coming out of service. I think it's important to remember that Petrotrin has been in bunkering for a number of years, but our Marbella barge was a single hull barge and would have had issues with passing certification. So with the barge out of service, we would have had a hiatus for a long time. We reviewed the bunkering operations. We think it's still a viable market. As a matter of fact, we've had a lot of inquiries as to whether or not we return to the bunkering service. And we have done some bunkering via pipeline, but now we have returned to the ship bunkering using this new double hull vessel that is on charter for us. This is an interim measure. Our intent is to eventually secure and purchase a double hull vessel at this Petrotrin zone. And we'll be operated by Petrotrin's personnel and continue our presence in the market.
Petrotrin has been in the bunker business for many, many years. It was discontinued in 2015 because our barge Mirabella was no longer viable. So since then, we have been looking at options of how we could go back into the business. One way is obviously we have to get our own new barge, which we're working on. But in the meantime, in order to get the business going, we've wet leased the vessel Valme B. This vessel is now with us and is going to start operation tomorrow, the 8th of April. We are going to be able to do bunkers in places that we've never been able to do it before. That is outside of Trinidad and Tobago. We can also even look at possibly lifting small cargoes if we have to some downtime. In terms of the bunker business though, we are going to be able to try to get back our volume that was lost, which is about somewhere between 100 to 120,000 barrels per month. And this is going to have a positive effect on our bottom line. If everything goes as planned, we should be making like around 1 to 3 million TT dollars per month, in addition to being able to pay all of our costs for these vessels. We've also had some good buy-in from the union, in which they have now agreed that they will allow their personnel to be on board 7 days on, 7 days off, which will help with customer satisfaction.
The resumption of this bunkering operation, at least offshore bunkering operation, is really welcome for Petrotrin's good fortune and future. It represents a method of getting rid of a lot of the low value fuel oil. Petrotrin struggles with fuel oil value that is most times less than the value of crude. Bunkering offers a way of offsetting that low value. We have always supported it as a member of staff, and now as a board member, I think it really bodes well to our overall economics.
I want to congratulate the members of the project team, led by the senior manager marketing, who have done a lot of work to make sure that we got to this point. I would have looked at the efforts required to bring this vessel into the water. I also want to congratulate our port and marine personnel. They have shown a lot of enthusiasm for this project. And indeed, three of our employees will be on board here at every point in time that the vessel is in operation. So it is going to give us not just economic advantage, but it's also going to do some capacity building, and that it helps improve the competence and development and exposure for our people. And therefore, it should allow for the sustainability of the business as we go forward.
The reintroduction of bunkering operations is expected to increase revenue. And while this vessel is on hire to Petrotrin, arrangements are being made for purchase of the company's own double-hull bunker barge.